Now, good morning, my colleagues. The lecture today is about malaria. It is parasitic infection which caused by mosquitoes, bite of mosquitoes, and characterized by acute manifestation, paroxysm of malaria, high fever, intoxication, and formation of gepidosplenomegaly, hemolytic jaundice. So it main indication of that infection. Now let's speak about infection agent, etiology of malaria, and infection agent is Plasmodium malaria. It is a type of protozoa, class of sporozoa, kind of Plasmodium. And transmissive mechanism of transmission, bite of mosquitoes, Anopheles, and there are 80 kinds of mosquitoes. And we know such kinds, type of Plasmodium malaria, Vivax, Avalia, Malaria, Falciparum. Plasmodium vivax cause the malaria vivax. Plasmodium ovale cause the ovale malaria. Plasmodium falciparum and Plasmodium malaria and Plasmodium falciparum, which cause the tropical malaria. Yes, and morbidity of malaria every year, nearby 500 million of the patients infected of those infection. And 3 million of the patients died from those infection every year. Those infections spread in tropical country with hot climate and spread in Turkey, Egypt, Greece, Crete, India, Thailand, Africa, Asia. Yes. And you see on the map spread of malaria in those countries. For example, India, Africa country, South America. And factors of transmissions is mosquitoes. Cause of infection is bite of mosquitoes. You see on this picture, bite of mosquitoes, class of Anopheles and Culex. Areal of population of those mosquitoes spread in tropical countries, countries with hot climate, and you know, those countries in Asia, Africa, South America, yes, characterize spreading of those kinds of mosquitoes. Yes, and let's speak about etiology of life cycle of Plasmodium malaria. So there are two phases of living cycle of those mosquitoes. For example, sporogonia and schizogonia. Sporogonia lasts in the body of mosquitoes. And schizogonia lasts in human body, in the organism of patient. So let's speak about those cycle, and in the face of schizogonia, formation of gametes, plasmodium, sporozoids, increasing of concentration of infections in salivary glands of mosquitoes. And so, bite of mosquitoes and schizont penetration to the organism of the patients and formation of tissue schizogonia, infected hepatocytes. It is exoerythrocyte phase of infection. When infected, the hepatocytes. And next phase of schizogonia is erythrocyte schizogonia, when schizont penetrate to blood and infected erythrocytes. In hepatocyte, in tissue schizogonia, formation of trophozoites, schizonts, merozoids. And the phase of tissue schizogonia lasts, for example, in Plasmodium falciparum, 6 days, in Plasmodium vivax, 8 days, in Plasmodium ovale, 9 days, in Plasmodium malaria, 15 days. And reproduction of plasmodium in the erythrocytes cause the destruction of blood cells, formation of parasitemia, and characterized by formation of fever, intoxication, activation of immune cells, activation of phagocytes, macrophages, synthesis of immune mediator, synthesis of opsonin, agglutinins, activation of T lymphocytes, synthesis of cytokines. So it characterized by endotoxinemia, parasitemia, which causes the increasing of the temperature and increasing of syndrome of intoxication. Then decreasing of parasitemia, activation of immune response, synthesis of antibodies, block of immune complex, endotoxins, and elimination in from macroorganism. And decreasing of parasitemia, but maybe reactivation of infection because plasmodium keep in different cells, in phagocytes, macrophages. And then maybe reactivation of infection, penetration, destruction of phagocytes, penetration parasites in the blood, and relapse of parasitemia, reactivation of infection. For example, reactivation of infection after 1 or 2 months, it is early relapse of malaria, of infection. Plasmodium falciparum development in capillaries of internal organs and adhesion of plasmodium in membranes of erythrocytes, penetrate to erythrocytes, and then it characterized by destruction of erythrocytes and increasing of manifestation of syndrome of infection, fever, intoxication. Sometimes formation of fulminant, hypotoxic forms, malignant forms of malaria. It's characterized by formation of toxic shock, polyorgans insufficiency, and death of the patients. Sometimes formation early relapses of infection in cases of immunodeficiency syndrome. Sometimes duration of infection may be different, months, sometimes years. For example, duration of falciparum malaria may be from 1 up to 2 years. Duration of vivax malaria from 2 up to 4 years. Duration of ovale malaria from 3 up to 6 years. And duration of malaria from 3 up to 20 years. So really very long time last malaria is caused by Plasmodium malaria. On this picture, you see the mechanism of transmission of infection of malaria. You see bite of mosquitoes. In organism of mosquitoes, formation of gametocytes. And gametocytes keep in the life of mosquitoes. Then bite of mosquitoes. When sporozoites penetrate to organism of the patients. Then sporozoites penetrate to liver. It is tissue schizogonia. When formation tissue variants of schizogonia, destruction of hepatocytes, development of merozoites in the liver. Then merozoites penetrate to blood and invasion erythrocyte, cause the destruction of erythrocytes and cause the formation of gametocytes, and then gametocytes penetration to organism of mosquitoes, and in organism of mosquitoes formation of sporogonia, when formation of sporozoans, and then after bite of mosquitoes, it caused the invasion of the next patient. You see the living cycle of mosquitoes. You see period of sporogonia when mosquitoes penetrate to organism of mosquitoes. Formation of sporogonia. Then formation of sporozoites in organism of mosquitoes, keep of infection in saliva gland of mosquitoes. Then after bite of mosquitoes, sporozoans migrate to organism of the patient and penetration to hepatocytes. And merozoites live in hepatocyte, and then it penetrate to blood, and merozoites penetrate to erythrocyte. So there are two phases, yes. Tissue schizogonia in the liver and erythrocytes schizogonia in red cells of blood of the patients. Yes, and in during erythrocyte schizogonia for formation, trophozoites, and then it causes the formation of gametocytes, which penetrate to blood, and then those gametocytes penetrate to organism of mosquitoes. Yes, so it is a living cycle or a cycle of plasmodium of malaria. And let's speak about cycle of living of plasmodium, stage of development of plasmodium of malaria. For example, we spoke about tissue schizogonia in the liver, in the organism of the patient. And it lasts from 23 up to 27 days. It is tissue schizogonia in the liver. It is exoerythrocyte stage of development of plasmodium. Next phase is erythrocyte schizogonia in organism of the patient. And erythrocyte schizogonia lasts from 5 up to 11 days. During erythrocyte schizogonia formation, amoebic-like schizont, merula, macro and micro gametocytes. And after bite of mosquitoes, gametocytes penetrate to organism of mosquitoes and formation of sporogonia in organism of mosquitoes. And sporogonia in organism of mosquitoes lasts from 16 up to 21 days. From 16 up to 21 days. So it is stage of development of plasmodium in organism of mosquitoes and in organism of the patient. We must remember scientist which discovered malaria plasmodium. You must remember those names. For example, Charles-Louis Alphonse Laveran, it is reveal plasmodium, describe those infection in 1889 year. It is scientists from France, and he was prize of Nobel Prize in 1807. And next scientist with discovery of mechanism of transmission of plasmodium. It estimate that factors of transmission of infection is mosquitoes, kinds of anopheles. And he was prized of Nobel Prize in 1902. Those scientists from England. Let's speak about erythrocyte schizogonia. You see erythrocyte schizogonia in organism of the patient. You see blood smear and infiltration of erythrocytes. Many variants of plasmodium, of merules. schizont, trophozoites, formation in erythrocytes. You see blood smear of the patients with malaria. You see many erythrocytes which keep those red corpuscles. Yes, it is different stage of formation of plasmodium. On those smear, the blood of the patient with tropical malaria, and you see the erythrocytes, big erythrocytes, with elements of plasmodium in the center of the cells. It is a blood smear of the patients with Plasmodium falciparum. You see erythrocyte schizogonia, you see infiltration of plasmodium of erythrocytes, you see erythrocytes with elements of plasmodium. Those pictures we can indicate, reveal on microscopia of blood smear. You see the phase of formation of gametocytes of the patients, for example, macrogametocytes of plasmodium falciparum, macrogametocytes of plasmodium ovale, macrogametocytes of plasmodium malaria, and macrogametocytes of Plasmodium vivax. So it is phase of erythrocyte schizogonia. You see electron microscopy of erythrocytes in the patients with Plasmodium malaria. Erythrocyte schizogonia, elements of plasmodium in erythrocyte by electron methods of microscopy. Those element. You see phases of development of gametocytes of plasmodium vivax. You see ring forms, mater ring forms, trophozoites, schizont, formation of schizont, mater schizont, and then formation of gametocytes, which cause the destruction of erythrocytes, and when gametocytes penetrate to blood, and then it penetrates to organism of mosquitoes. You see male, female gametocytes, male gametocytes. Yes, it formation in organism of the patients. Let's speak about epidemiology of infection. Sources of infection is the patients and carriers. More often carriers diagnosis reveal in tropical countries, in countries with hot climate. Mechanism of transmission is bite of mosquito, transmissive mechanism, bite of mosquitoes. But sometimes, very seldom, it can be parenteral mechanism. For example, blood transfusion, from donors, yes, which was infected by malaria. Or maybe diagnostic manipulation, parenteral manipulation. And sometimes congenital transplacent variant of infection. And it's characterized by different forms of infection. It is for those forms of indication in Africa, Asia, yes, in endemic region of malaria. So it is tolerance forms when formation resistance to those infection. What cases of tolerance of infection? Formation of synthesis of S hemoglobin, it causes the formation of resistance of malaria. And enzymes, glucose-6-phosphatase dehydrogenase, deficit of those enzymes, cause the formation of tolerance forms of infection, which cause the formation of persistence, resistance from those infection. There are no clinical forms of malaria in those patients with synthesis of S hemoglobin and deficiency of glucose-6-phosphatase dehydrogenase. Let's speak about pathogenesis of malaria. For example, we know that plasmodium penetrate to blood, then it penetrate to liver, formation of tissue schizogonia, and then after tissue schizogonia, plasmodium penetrate to erythrocytes and cause the destruction of red blood cells. And it causes the destruction of red blood cells, destruction of infection agent, which causes the increasing of concentration of products of metabolism in blood, endotoxinemia, synthesis of increasing of concentration of erythrocytes proteins, histamine, serotonin, гемомеланин, increasing of concentration of катехоламин, activation of kininkalkrein system, increasing of concentration of fibrin, products of destruction of fibrin, which cause activation of microthrombosis, formation of thrombosis of blood vessels, and destruction of microcirculation of the patient. Then tropical malaria characterized by synthesis of toxic substance in blood. It characterized by formation of cytotoxic substance which keep in the cells of the patients. In the cells of macroorganisms, for example, in phagocytes, macrophages, endothelium cells, hepatocytes, neutrophils, and other cells. Let's speak about pathogenesis of tropical malaria. It's characterized by higher fever of higher level of exotoxinemia, endotoxinemia, destruction of blood vessels, activation of immune cells, synthesis inflammatory cytokines, destruction of blood vessels, formation of microthrombosis of blood vessels, and synthesis of toxic substances in the blood, and keep toxic substance in different cells. disturbances of metabolism, ischemia of internal organs, metabolic disorders of internal organs, activation of autoimmune mechanism, synthesis of immune complex, and immune complex causes the destruction of blood vessels. Sometimes activation of phagocytes, sometimes hyperactivation of phagocytes and synthesis of inflammational cytokines, which cause the formation of toxicometabolic syndrome, toxicometabolic syndrome of the patients, which cause the cardiovascular insufficiency, spasm of arterioles, disturbances of microcirculation, destruction of blood vessels of the brain, destruction of hepatocytes, formation of target organs. During parasitemia, it causes the formation of hyperplasia, of mesenchymal syndrome, of the liver, spleen, yes, hyperplasia of mesenchymal tissue, of activation of phagocyte system of mesenchymal tissue in the liver, spleen, and in bone marrow, because we observe the formation of splenomegaly, hepatomegaly in the patients of malaria. Hyperfunction of the spleen, yes, hypersplenism or hypersplenism. Anemia, because destruction of erythrocyte. Лейкопения, thrombocytopenia, because immune complex cause the destruction of blood cells, because spleen cause the destruction of blood cells and formation pancytopenia. And so, because formation of parasitemia, synthesis of exotoxins, destruction of the cells, destruction of hepatocytes, erythrocytes, increasing of concentration on immune mediator, endogenic pyrogens, for example, interleukin-1, interleukin-8. So it causes the formation of increasing of the temperature, formation of the fever. It is early symptoms of infection. And there are different variants of the fever. It can be irregular fever. Yes, it is a formation of febris intermittens in the patients and paroxysm of malaria, so it is characterized by connect with such phenomenon by formation two generation of parasites in the blood. Some generation, some for example two generation, yes, and it caused the formation of irregular fever. But then formation paroxysm of malaria and rhythmic character of paroxysm after 48 hours, for example, in cases of Plasmodium vivax and Plasmodium ovale, and paroxysm of malaria after 72 hours in cases of Plasmodium malaria. So, rhythmic character of paroxysm after 48 hours in cases of Plasmodium malaria, vivax and ovale, and paroxysm after 72 hours in cases of Plasmodium malaria. Sometimes formation of prolonged forms when formation persistente plasmodium in the blood, and then formation of specific immune response and synthesis of antibodies in the blood. And those antibody connect with antigen and elimination those immune complex antigen and exotoxins from macroorganism. Let's speak about immune response in pathogenesis of plasmodium in malaria. For example, we spoke that seen activation of immune response, activation of T lymphocytes, B lymphocytes, humoral immune response, synthesis of opsonins, synthesis antibodies, agglutinins. Then we spoke that those antibodies connect antigens, products of plasmodium, products of autolysis, destruction of the cells of macroorganism, and elimination of those elements from organism of the patients. Decreasing of intoxication and stabilization of clinic and recovering of the patient. But some of plasmodium keep in the cells, in phagocytes, macrophages, and in those patients may be formation relapse of infection. What's morphological results of examination of the patient? After death of the patient, we indication dystrophy of internal organs, dystrophy of the reins, dystrophy of the liver, edema of brain, edema of lung, formation of extravasates and destruction of capillaries, and formation of specific granulomas around the veins, formation of specific granulomas around the blood vessels. Dystrophy of myocard, hemorrhagical elements in different tissue, for example, in the myocard, epicard, endocard. And formation of malaria pigment in the tissue when we indication in microscope, when we examination the cells of macroorganism, and formation of dystrophy of internal organs, dystrophy of the liver, renal, formation of reactive hepatitis, nephritis, nephrosis, and destruction of neurocyte, and formation of neuropathia of the patient. Let's speak about the clinic of malaria. Clinic of malaria is characterized by a period of incubation. Period of incubation in Plasmodium vivax in average from 10 up to 14 days. Sometimes some months last period of incubation from 6 up to 14 months. Period of incubation is Plasmodium ovale last from 7 up to 20 days. Plasmodium falciparum, period of incubation in Plasmodium falciparum last from 8 up to 16 days. Period of incubation in Plasmodium malaria lasts from 25 up to 42 days. Then clinic period, it characterized by sometimes prodromal period, general malaise, self-fibrillated temperature. So maybe prodromal period, asthenia, insomnia, self-fibrillated temperature. And then paroxysm of malaria. Paroxysm of malaria. It's characterized by three phases: chills, fever, and sweaty. Three phases of paroxysm of malaria: chills, fever, and sweating. Chills last from 1 up to 3 hours. Fever, period of the fever, lasts from 6 up to 8 hours. Then period sweating lasts from 2 up to 4 hours. Let's speak about clinic. We continue to speak about clinic of malaria. So sometimes we observe the initial fever before paroxysm, formation of paroxysm of malaria. We can observe initial fever. It's characterized by interference of plasmodium of malaria in blood of the patients, and characterized by headache, myalgia, rash on the skin, bronchospasm, dizziness, lumbar pain, sometimes diarrhea, gastroenteritis, hyperemia of face, injection of sclera conjunctiva, and hyperemia of skin. Yes. What about the blood picture in the patient? The indication anemia, yes, because destruction erythrocytes. Leukopenia, it's characterized by hypersplenism, hypersplenism. Reticulocytosis, it characterizes regeneration of erythrocytes. Thrombocytopenia, because hyperfunction of the spleen, hypersplenism of the patients. Anisopoikilocytosis, because formation of anemia. And increasing of blood sedimentation rate. Then period of apraxia after paroxysm of malaria formation, period of decreasing of the temperature and period of apraxia. And it's characterized by jaundice. It is hemolytic jaundice, increasing of non-conjugated fracture of bilirubin. Sometimes increasing of transaminase, because we spoke about destruction of hepatocytes, yes, tissue schizogonia in organism of the patient. Hepatosplenomegaly, because hyperplasia of mesenchymal tissue. And asthenia, decreasing of the weight of the patients, deficit of the weight, mass of the patient. Let's speak about about the clinic of tropical malaria, for example, which is fulminant forms, happy toxic forms, malignant forms of infection, because developments of developments of malaria and destruction of blood capillaries of the patients, disturbances of microcirculation, metabolic disorders, formation of toxic shock, coma malaria, yes, coma malaria. It is the results of higher level of exotoxinemia, endotoxinemia, synthesis of mediator, immune mediator, spasm of blood vessels, microthrombosis, disturbances of microcirculation, polyorgans insufficiency, cardiovascular insufficiency, renal insufficiency, respiratory insufficiency, dyspnea, acrocyanosis, diffusion cyanosis, decreasing of diuresis, increasing of concentration urea and creatinine in blood. And what clinic? For example, agitation, convulsions, colonic cramps, encephalopathia, meningeal symptoms, neuropathia, formation of pathological reflexes, decreasing of arterial blood pressure, diffusion cyanosis. Yes, so it characterized by coma malaria. Sometimes the indication phase of compensation, subcompensation and decompensation. It depends of progressive of polyorgans insufficiency. In phase of subcompensation, formation of respiratory insufficiency, renal insufficiency. In phase of decompensation, it is characterized by polyorgans insufficiency and metabolic disorders of internal organs and disturbances of microcirculation and metabolic disorders of macroorganism and death of the patient. Acute renal insufficiency characterized by tubular necrosis, decreasing of diuresis, oliganuria, hyperazotemia, hyperkalemia, metabolic acidosis, increasing of the level of urea creatinine in blood. What another clinic of tropical malaria? Formation of not only coma malaria, yes, but in the patients with tropical malaria, formation hemoglobin uric fever, hemoglobin uric fever. It is a complication more often after treatments of the patients after administer. Gematoshizotropic medicates, which causes this massive destruction of erythrocytes. And it causes the formation intravascular hemolysis of erythrocytes. After treatments, for example, in cases of treatments of quinine, and it's characterized by the fever, myalgia, pain in lumbar region, decreasing of diuresis, uremic syndrome, myalgia, and hemolytic jaundice. Hemolytic jaundice, increasing of bilirubin, of non-conjugated fracture, sometimes increasing of transaminase of the patients. In hemoglobinuric fever, we reveal dark urine. Dark urine has its connection with hemolysis of erythrocytes. Acute renal insufficiency, formation of azotemia, pancytopenia, anemia. So, in tropical malaria may be formation hemorrhagical forms of malaria. Hemorrhagical forms of malaria when we reveal formation of toxic shock and disseminated hemorrhagical fever. Decreasing of blood pressure, respiratory insufficiency, renal insufficiency, activation of fibrinolytic abilities, increasing of concentration of products of disturbances of fibrin, synthesis of activation of kininkalicrine system, formation of thrombosis of blood vessels, destruction of endothelium of blood capillaries, and formation of disseminated intravascular coagulation. And it's characterized by formation of hemorrhagical rash on the skin. Rash, hemorrhagical rash, massive hemorrhagical element on the skin. Hemorrhagia in internal organs. For example, in the myocardium, in the muscles, in the lung. Hemorrhagia in the brain, in the adrenal glands. And in this patient, we reveal nausea, vomiting with blooded mixtures, diarrhea with blooded mixtures, bleeding from nose, bleeding from stomach. Yes. So we spoke about clinic, different forms of infection. Yes. Spoke about clinic of malaria, vivax ovale, malaria. We spoke about tropical malaria, clinic of tropical malaria, and complications when we indication in tropical malaria. Yes, edema of brain, edema of lung, toxic shock, hemorrhagical forms, disseminated hemorrhagical syndrome, hemolytic uric fever, malaria of coma malaria, and other complications. And now we must confirm diagnosis. Yes, what findings very important for diagnostic of malaria? For example, geography, anamnesis. Yes, and traveling the patients to different countries with hot climate, Africa, Asia, South America, for example. Bite of mosquitoes in anamnesis. Yes. Then prodromal period. Then formation of paroxysm of malaria, formation of intermittent fever, paroxysm malaria, and different interval of paroxysm, for example, an interval with paroxysm, for example, 1 or 2 days. In vivax ovale, malaria interval with paroxysm is 1 day. And paroxysm formation in ovale malaria in the evening and in vivax ovale in the morning. Yes, paroxysm of the fever in ovale malaria in the evening and in cases of vivax malaria, paroxysm in the morning, in the afternoon. And interval of paroxysm is 1 day. In cases of Plasmodium malaria, interval between paroxysm is 2 days, 2 days, and formation of prolonged forms of infection. What are other findings important for diagnostic? Gepatosplenomegaly. Yes, because activation of mesenchymal reaction of internal organs. Anemia, pancytopenia, leukopenia, thrombocytopenia. Yes, for blood picture. Increasing of bilirubin, hyperbilirubinemia of non-conjugated fracture because hemolysis of erythrocyte. So those findings important for diagnostic. But we must remember that must be a laboratory confirm of diagnosis, laboratory diagnostic. And the main examination in malaria, examination in a drop of blood when we indication on microscope plasmodium malaria. And blood smear examination on microscope when we reveal infected erythrocytes, different forms, merles, schizonts, so which keep in erythrocytes. Blood smear, we spoke those pictures, and examination of drop of blood of the patients. When we indication plasmodium malaria, so we reveal type of malaria, vivax, avalia, falciparum, malaria. Then destruction more than 5% of erythrocytes. Yes, in malaria. And serological test when the indication antibodies in blood. Antibodies in blood. For example, serological reactions. Indirect hemagglutination. And methods of immunofluorescence. When the indication antibodies, immune complex with methods of fluorescence. Let's speak about differentiation of infection. Differentiation of infection. So, malaria we differentiate with others infection. For example, typhoid fever, meningococcal infection, hemorrhagical fever with renal syndrome, acute intestinal infection, viral hepatitis, sepsis, cholangitis, so such infections. For example, typhoid fever, it is infection which caused by Salmonella typhi, febris continua, constant variant of the fever, Roseolus rash on the skin, gepotest splenomegaly, status typhosus and formation ulcers in small intestine. So, oral mechanism of transmission. Meningococcal infection characterized by the acute manifestation, high fever, formation of meningococcemia, formation of hemorrhagical rash on the skin, and then formation of meningitis, meningoencephalitis in cases of meningococcemia and meningitis, meningeal syndrome, inflammational alteration of the liver, sometimes nasopharyngitis, so it is local forms of meningococcal infection. Hemorrhagical fever characterized by the fever and formation of acute renal insufficiency. Zoonotic infection and sources of infection is rodents. In anamnesis, contact with rodents live in the village, for example. Those viruses cause the destruction of glomerulus, formation of nephrosis nephritis, and we observe the some phase of infection, period of the fever, then period of renal insufficiency, decreasing of diuresis, uremic syndrome, and then period of recovering diuresis and polyuria in those patients. And main methods of diagnostic is serological test of the patient. When the indication, antibodies in blood. Next, acute intestinal infection. So it's characterized by acute manifestation, gastrointestinal syndrome, increasing of the temperature, syndrome of intoxication, and gastrointestinal syndrome. Anamnesis, alimentary anamnesis, for example, and food, water, contact, ways of transmission, and infection agent may be Salmonella, Shigella, Escherichia coli, Yersinia, and others bacteria. Formation of gastrointestinal system syndrome, gastroenteritis, gastroenterocolitis, enterocolitis, gastritis, syndrome of dehydration, and Tony Krebs. Yes, Tony Krebs is results of syndrome of dehydration. And diagnostic of intestinal infection is copra culture, urine culture, and serological test. Next, differentiation with viral hepatitis. Viral hepatitis. It is a parenchyma jaundice. Yes. In malaria, the indication hemolytic jaundice, increasing of non-conjugated fracture of bilirubin. And viral hepatitis, it is hepatocellular jaundice. It is hepatic jaundice, parenchyma jaundice, which caused the destruction of hepatocytes. And it's characterized by increasing of bilirubin by conjugated fracture, increasing of transaminase, alanine, aminotransferase, aspartate, aminotransferase. So syndrome hyperbilirubinemia of conjugated fracture and syndrome of cetosis. Indication, the virus from blood by polymerase reaction, yes, and indication, antibodies to the virus in blood by ELISA methods. Sepsis characterized by higher fever too, but it characterized by formation of primary focus of infection, then generalization of infection, formation of prolonged bacteremia, formation of gectic fever, atypical fever, gectic fever, hemorrhagical rash, hemorrhagical exanthems, gepatomegaly, splenomegaly, formation of touchy organs, polyorgans insufficiency, and formation of metastatic focus of infection in the liver, lung, brain, joints, and others localization. Main methods of diagnostic of sepsis is gemoculture, indication of gemoculture in the patient during increasing of the temperature. Yes, differentiation with local forms of infection, for example, cholangitis, pneumonia, nephritis, and others infection. In cholangitis, for example, we indication pain in right iliac region, symptoms Ortner, Kera, Nusser, Phrenicus, and others. So such differentiation of different other infection and malaria. And we must remember, we must administer examination on malaria, drop of blood and blood smear of the patients with prolonged fever, of the patients when the temperature is more than 4 days. You see the character of the temperature, atypical fever, atypical fever. You see the temperature, list of the temperature. You see the blood pressure and days of infection, sometimes laboratory test. Febris intermittens. You see interval between paroxysm of malaria. 1 day, yes, or 2 days. We spoke about those diagnostic. You see days of infection, and you see maybe it is Vivax ovale or Vivax Plasmodium Vivax or Plasmodium ovale in those patients. Yes, between because interval between paroxysm is 1 day. Interval between paroxysm of malaria, Plasmodium malaria, is 2 days. You see, maybe it is Plasmodium malaria because interval between paroxysm of infection is 2 days. Yes, 2 days. Maybe regular fever in tropical malaria. So interval 2 days, yes, or irregular fever, it's characterized by tropical malaria, Plasmodium falciparum, hyperpyretic temperature, complication of infection, marked intoxication, geography anamnesis, complication, for example, toxic shock, hemorrhagical syndrome, hemoglobin uric fever in Plasmodium falciparum in tropical malaria. Let's speak about treatments of malaria. Treatment of malaria. We administer such medicates, for example, gametogizotropic medicates, chinin, quinin, hingamin, proguanil, delagil, chlorahin, pirimetamin, sulfanilamid, tetracycline, artemisin, Meflahin. So they are gametogizotropic medicates which active to in face of gametotropic schizogonia. Cause the destruction of plasmodium in erythrocytes because it is gametogizotropic medicates. Next, histoschizotropic medicates, medicates which active on tissue phase of schizogonia in the liver, for example. It is primahin, hinacid. Primahin, hinacid. Next medicates, gametocyte. destruction of gametocyte, gametocyte destruction activity, pyrimethamine, primahin, hinocyt, proguanil. So it is gametocyte medicates, which cause the destruction of gametocytes in blood of the patient. Spermatocyte medicates in tropical malaria. Pyrimethamin, proguanil. Spermatocyte medicates in tropical malaria. Pyrimethamin, proguanil. What about the scheme of the treatments? There is the initial scheme of the treatment in cases of Plasmodium vivax and Avalli. It is gametotropic medicates. In cases of Plasmodium vivax and Avalli, only those Plasmodium, yes? Initial scheme of the treatments on the first day, Delagil, 1 gram plus 0.5 gram after 6 hours. It is the first day. Second day. Delagil dose is 0.5. And third day, Delagil 0.5. So, in cases of Plasmodium vivax and Avalli. So, it is initial scheme of the treatment. In cases of Plasmodium malaria, we administer Delagil during 4 days plus 4th days. In cases of Plasmodium malaria. It is the first phase of the treatment, so when we administer gametoschizotropic medicates. Next phase, histoschizotropic medicates. Histoschizotropic treatments, we administer primahin. So histoschizotropic treatments, we administer in cases of Plasmodium vivax and Plasmodium ovale. We administer primahin, dose is 15 mg, every day during 14 days. So it is prophylactic of recidive of infection, prophylactic of relapse of infection. So two phases of the treatment. At first, gametoschizotropic treatments, and next, histoschizotropic treatment. Next, what about treatments of tropical malaria? Gametoschizotropic treatment medicates. Hinin, 0.6, 3 times during 7 days. Or Fensidar, which is combined medicates, consist of sulfadoxin and pyrimethamine. 3 capsules, 1 day, 1 time. Next variant, tetracycline, dose is 0.5, 3 times per day. Or doxycycline, 0.2 gram. Per day during 7 days. Because Plasmodium falciparum is resistant to the Lagil, yes, and we administer only such medicates, Chinin, Fansidar, Tetracycline, and Doxycycline. Sometimes we recommend combine scheme of the treatment. For example, chinin plus doxycycline. Мефлохин плюс артемизин. So combine treatments of malaria. Хинин плюс доксициклин, мефлохин плюс артемизин. For pregnancy woman, we administer артемизин. Artemisin in average dose. So such treatment of tropical malaria. Treatments of fulminant forms of malaria, tropical malaria, malignant forms of tropical malaria. Quinine intravenously, 20 milligram on 1 kilogram of mass of patients per day. Then oral forms of treatments. In cases of acute renal insufficiency, we decreasing dose of chinin, for example, from 10 up to 50 milligram per day. Yes, in cases acute renal insufficiency, we decreasing dose of chinin, for example, from 10 up to 15 milligram on 1 kilogram. In cases of treatments of toxic shock or coma of malaria, we administer colloids, crystalloids. Volume of infusion therapy from 10 up to 15 milliliter on 1 kilogram. Steroids, prednisolone or dexamethasone. For example, prednisolone is dose is 2 milligram on 1 kilogram of mass of patients. Dexazone, for example, 8 milligram per day. In phase of subcompensation, we administer mega doses of steroids. For example, 20 milligram of dexamethasone or 10 milligram on 1 kilogram of mass of patients in of prednisolone. In cases of renal insufficiency, polyorgans insufficiency, we recommend formation administer hemodialysis, hemofiltration, hemosorption, and ultrafiltration. So such methods of the treatments, fulminant, malignant, hypotoxic forms of tropical malaria. Prevention of malaria. We must about the, remember, yes, about methods of prophylactic, of prevention of malaria. So fighting with mosquitoes, Anopheles. Hemoprophylactic, for example, before traveling to hyperendemic region, hemoprophylaxis. So, for example, Molation, Propascur, Abet, Emagocytes, Medicates, Piretrum, Fenitriol. Yes, and biological methods of fighting with the plasmodium with the fish gambusia. It is a fish which eat mosquitoes. Gambusia, yes, it is a fish which eat mosquitoes. And drainage of swamp, melioration, yes, for fighting with mosquitoes. Maybe individual prevention. Before traveling to endemic region, we administer Fansidar, Hinin, Hingamin before three days to traveling to endemic region. Every day. 1 or 2 days per week. During living in endemic region. Every day, 1 or 2 times per week. Or every day. Fansidar, Hinin, Hingamin before 3 days to traveling to endemic region. Then prevention of vivax malaria. It is seasonal prevention. We administer Delagil 15 milligram per day. Sometimes we recommend repellents, aerosols for fighting with mosquitoes, and sometimes vaccine prophylactic, because now there is synthesis of vaccine to Shizont vaccine and Sparazont vaccine, which cause the synthesis of antibodies in blood and prevention of infection. You see, it is gambusia, it is fish which kill and eat the larva of malaria, plasmodium malaria. Yes, gambusia. Thank you for your time, my colleagues. Goodbye.